Hey all, this is Ursa, and welcome back to XCOM. What are we doing here? What am I doing? I don't know, we're killing some A's, and we know there's a double ethereal patch just waiting out there for us. So we gotta be just a wee bit careful as we start moving up here. They've been moving back, but they could be patrolling through again. The last time we saw, they're kind of in there. The third row down, so to speak. Now, we're a little worried, honestly, about the ethereal power. Two of those can drop pretty much a full health mech, you know, straight no chaser, so we gotta be... Oh, crap. I thought he was... That was cover still. That's what I get. We're trying to do this quickly. But yeah, so... We gotta be very, very careful about how we deploy, and we gotta make sure if we see an ethereal, we drop at least one right off. If we can at least get one down, then the threat of just losing a mech in one go kind of disappears. So that's more or less the gist of what I'm gonna try to get through here. I'm gonna try to hit that pack in a way that I can set up probably a double proxy and a rocket and just annihilate one of the ethereals, and if we can go ahead and take a Muton Elite down with it, I'm not gonna shed any tears, obviously. So that's kind of my idea. This movement on Tyler is off. I'm gonna move him out here so we can get a little closer. Everyone else is gonna set up Overwatches though. You know that pack's gonna keep moving here. We constantly have quasi-vision on them, so that's gonna be a thing. They haven't moved. They're still standing in that third row here. Gotta be a little careful. And they're moving, and they're moving, and they're moving to the second one now, more or less. Okay. So the meld went away, but again, that's not my major concern here. My major concern is dealing with this in a very aggressive way. So, let's see. So we know there's double ethereal. It looks like there's three heavy floaters that we saw running around. Plus, yeah, and a Muton Elite at least. There's another ethereal in there, though, so I can't really mess around with that. We're getting lucky here, obviously. We're getting a little bit of this vision that we technically shouldn't be getting, so I'm not gonna, you know, shake a stick at that. I'm pretty happy about that. What I'm gonna try to do, though, is get into a position down here where I can kinda get a little closer and get a better position on them. This is luckily blocking line of sight right now. So I'm gonna try to use that to my advantage. Let me get, in case we just spot another pack here and try to blow us up. Really? What's... Why is my mech unable to jump down here? I'm really not that far off. I don't understand. Is it me or is everyone having trouble moving today? Hey, look at this. Okay, no, Nova can move. Alright, Nova can move. That's fine. This is blue. This is blue. That's fine. Okay, why is this mech so much trouble moving? Cairo should easily be able to get down. Yeah, there we go. That was so bizarre. Okay. But we're going to try to get everyone kind of down here as much as possible. We'll have high fire support from there, just so we can get a little closer in on this, and we can make the outsiders, not the outsiders, the ethereals. I've been saying that wrong the whole time, probably. Make the ethereals kind of suffer for taking vision of us. We're not sure exactly where the rest of the alien packs are. But this is by far the most dangerous one, so we're going to blow a lot of consumables to make sure this ends quickly, so that threat is gone for good. Hank, like I said, I'm going to try to set up his fire support up here. He should be just fine in that position. Tony needs to be up front, because that shotgun's not going to get anywhere without that. And let's see, we need, obviously, our Pathfinder to kind of be able to jump in the front line as well. I don't want to go too far, lest we trigger them accidentally on this kind of weird position that we're sitting in. Remember, the heavy floaters in the Muton Elite are no joke either. We got to be very careful on that activation. I'm going to get Ray to kind of cover Overwatch from high ground and potential smokes. And Plankbow, I don't want to get caught out by something out there. We're going to steady up. Instead of Overwatch is everywhere. Like I said, this is all about being careful, making sure that we take a good engagement on this. We don't want to take a last move. Oh crap, we just saw the heavy floater. Because that's going to spell death for someone. There's just too much power here. And they're moving out. Okay, they're moving away. They're moving away. We'll probably go into the next bay here and try to follow them out. We may trigger another pack while we're doing that, but we should be able to handle that and still pursue this main pack if need be. I'm going to keep leading with Cairo. It feels always a good idea, because no matter what, you can always pitch a grenade if something gets spotted, but it looks like we're pretty clear. They may be coming back the next turn, so we're not going to go crazy on this. We're just going to kind of get in position. It's nice and easy. Keep the frontliners in the front, everyone else carrying up the rear. And we should be able to get a pretty good drop on these guys when they won't expect it.
Rolling out.
In this case, I think I'm going to start bringing people a little closer together. Hank can always get high ground with his Archangel, which is the advantage of that armor, obviously. So, Ray, wow, you are shining bright, buddy. I'm going to move you away from that position. That's actually making me go blind. Hank, where you at, buddy? There you are. You're going to go down here.
10-4.
Attaboy. Can you get shiny, too? Oh, Hank is shiny now, too. Look at that. That lighting is just on him. That spotlight loves... That camera loves that man. All right, let's get... Yeah, I'll put our Rocketeer back here. I would put him there, but again, like I said, I want to have anything coming out of that side round. So let's put that up. Coming back, or are you moving away? What are you doing? You're just sitting there, huh? He's just sitting there. Okay, that's fine. And they're coming back. Okay, so this is actually good. This is actually good, because we can go ahead and get a serious drop on these guys here. So we have a rocket that'll leech there. We have command on Ray that can get us another explosion. So this is as good as we're going to get a chance to hit this pack. So I think we got to go now. What I'm going to double check now is that we're not going to walk in the middle of something else while we're trying to get these guys down. Looks like this is it. Looks like, yeah. Looks like a 6 alien pack. So my guess is, if we take a look at what we kind of have from our intel, could be an overmind, which is not looking too good for me. But then we got at least one Muton Elite. And then probably 3 floaters. So yeah, 2 Ethereals, Muton Elite, and 3 Heavy Floaters. Looks like what we've got there. That is a nasty pack by anyone's definition. We're going to see these guys now. There's an Overmind. Oh, Jesus, there's an Overmind. Okay, that's not good. And they ran off, which is not good. I needed them to be closer. But look at the HP on that SOB. Look at this crap. That is wild, dude. Yep, it's an Overmind. And this thing does ludicrous damage. Enemy defense 40 because screw you. Alright. This is not going to be pretty. Can we get a proxy up there, though? Okay, we still get a proxy right here. And luckily, we can get a proxy in 2 places. So this is pretty perfect. We're going to have to probably take the Muton Elite on the chin. But that's okay. And we're definitely going to need a command from Ray to make this end. This is going to hurt like hell. But I think we can actually get corner position on the Ethereals from here as well, and the floaters with our handy-dandy smile mech. Yep, pretty much. So we have some flanks able to pull us off. We have, I think, a rocket that'll let us do this as well, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. Yep, there's a high explosive with our name on it there. So we're probably going to go just raw damage here and see how much we can pull off. I would shred, but that may not do what I want it to at this point. Yeah. Yeah, the rest of it, we're going to be a little tight on movement. But Ray, can you command... Ray should be able to command, I think, our mech. We'll double check, but we need to put Ray in a safe place, too. He doesn't want to get face-boned by that thing. So where is our double... We're going to double proxy this. I am not screwing around. This pack is the nasty. It is the nasty, so we're not going to screw around with it. That little... That second ethereal almost looks... puny by comparison, doesn't it? To that Overmind? Like, how much HP is that? Good God. It had to be the level 9 boss for the Ethereals, right? It couldn't be just a normal level 9 boss. That'd be, like, the worst one. I mean, I don't know. The Titan's pretty bad. Sectapod level 9 boss is pretty bad. I'll give you that much. So, Ray, you can command from here, no problem. And then we can put you in someplace safe. Maybe good to get him someplace safe, though, and then throw a smoke while commanding. Because the Ethereals... aim is kind of a hybrid ability. It's not necessarily one or the other. It's kind of psychic will defense for damage, and also it needs to be accurate. So we can use smoke to mitigate some of that. I know Ray doesn't have combat cocaine, but it'll be good regardless. So double proxy. Like I said, I am not screwing around with this at all. Then we're going to launch a heavy explosive. So what do we have? 3 heavy floaters. We don't see one of them, which is disturbing. That I don't like so much. Hank is going to need to figure out some way to get eyes on this, and it's going to be very difficult for him to do so. He's going to have to try and jet up here, but it's going to be very difficult. I don't know. We might have to wait till next turn for him, but either way, Plank Bob is going to go ahead and unleash hell on the worst pack we have facing us right now, and hopefully between this amount of damage, we should be able to wreck stuff pretty well. We're going to have to go pretty aggro after this on the Overmind, though, because he does heal, remember? So we got to be quite forthcoming with the murder. Let's center the blast on him. see how that's gonna go.
I don't even know what happened.
Ideally, he'll evaporate three of those things there. And we'll see how it's gonna go. But that overmind is no joke, man. I don't like it at all. I don't like it at all. Good damage. Good damage. And that explosion should hurt the overmind as well. Okay, a little extra damage. We definitely hit the other floater in some way. So that took off about half his health. Double proxy and high explosive took off half his health. That's how dangerous that individual is, which I don't like very much. Okay, so Tyler's gonna need to get out. Now we're gonna have to go ham on this thing. Gotta be a wee bit careful, but this takes us out of vision. So this shouldn't trigger any overwatch. I'm banking on that right now, because otherwise we can't really afford to have another pack come at us. There's the heavy floater though, and he's a lot closer than I thought he was. That's not great. 57%. So much defense. That's really, really not good. We can get a run and shoot here with Tony Blair. Run and hide and find! we can get that. We can increase hollow, actually. This may bait out the grenade from the Mutant Elite, but I will gladly take a grenade to the face if I can drop this ethereal. I think that would be worth its weight in gold right now. 57. If this hits, great. If not, and there's a reflection, but we have hollow regardless. It's expected. We get a lot of reflections here. Took three, which is unfortunate. We'll have to probably pitch a smoke at some point, but this gives us some flexibility. We're going to be in some rough patches with potential flanks, but we should be generally okay. It's going to be touch and go. So I'm not trying to commit to any statement right now. It's going to be very touch and go. No matter what, we're going to need Hank to get up.
Houston, we have liftoff.
And if he can't get a clean shot on this turn, which is highly unlikely, I'm probably going to use him to increase psychic defenses from people that are about to get pegged by this thing. That's not going to be good. All right, Tyler really doesn't have that much flexibility where we put him. All right, well, we're going to see what we can do here, because I need this stuff to start connecting a bit. There's a reflection. Double reflection.
I'm still operational.
Still operational for three damage. Try again. Three reflections in a row, which is not frustrating at all.
Armor systems are holding steady.
Bullshit.
Target
on many levels.
Standing.
Gonna run and gun here with a shotgun. That's ridiculous.
Nice. Going in for the kill.
Three reflections in a row. That's why you have to use explosive
moving
on these fuckers,
because
you'll never get lucky. When you need the shot, you'll never get lucky. 64. Again, we're not getting much better. Four reflections in a row. Wow, this game hates me today.
Adjusting aim.
Ugh. That really sucks, because we were banking on killing that thing, and we didn't get the kill. So now we've got a serious problem. All right. Tyler's gonna have to set me an overwatch. Ray. Now I realize you can get flanked by that heavy floater. This is not a great position to be in. Alright. Go ahead and Psy Inspire. I can't have anyone go freak on me here. Alright, we're gonna do two Psy Inspires to mitigate damage.
I give you strength.
And then we're gonna go have Tyler Psy Inspire in case this gets weird.
I give you strength.
And Ray. I just don't want him to get crit by a heavy floater, so he's gonna have to go here. I wanted to throw the smoke, but it's not gonna happen. Four reflections in a row is kind of bullshit, even for an overmind.
All right.
Obviously targeting the mech. 18 damage raw on this thing. 18. 18 people with abs fields. See how much damage that thing does? Answer: a lot. This is gonna hurt. Oof, not so good. There's six health too, so that's not good either. I was a little worried about the flank. I thought he might just toss a grenade because he had a bunch, but the risk didn't work out. We're gonna have to deal with this guy somehow now. Unfortunately, we're still in trouble as far as the big guy is concerned. I may need to proxy this again and pop another heavy damage thing. I'm not sure we're going to get a good swing on this. Hank, can you get over here somehow and get an eye on this overmind? I want you to get close enough so you can reflect. Is that seriously within range of him? Okay, well that's scary for Hank, because I don't want him to be reflecting on Hank. but I'm not sure if I can get the angle from here otherwise. It's gonna have to be... Really? Okay. That was despite the increased will, that's how much damage that thing did. So kind of ridiculous. Okay, we're gonna take some poundings here. This is not gonna be good. I'm glad we brought extra med kits. Nova took some pain here too, which is not good. Can we get some hollow up here as well, please? Actually did some damage for a change, nice. Okay, now this guy's gonna be a problem. We're gonna have to either panic him or something. Let's see how unlucky we get. What's your shot? 96 and 76, okay. We're gonna have to let Blair take... Blair can now take hit and runs. So we're gonna try to take some of these. Maybe we can get one of these in edgewise. 13 damage, not bad, not bad, not bad, not bad. Okay, he's almost down. We can drop him with an explosive, guaranteed, but I'm gonna try to save it if possible. I need to... Do I really need to ration him out? I kinda do. And this guy is still very much right here. Can he panic? How well can he panic? Not so good. What is he, immune to panic? Neural damping. Yep, he's immune to panic. Okay, well that's cute. They decided to put those on mutant elites these days. All right, Hank. Can you get me a kill? Can you make it work for daddy? Yep, we got the Overmind down.
X-ray neutralized.
Despite taking ludicrous damage from that thing, man. 18 damage after abs fields. That's so much. That's 60% of his damage is 18. So that leaves 10% to be 3. So 100% would have been 30. The thing does 30 raw. 30. 3-0. How is that in any way fair? Good lord. I don't think a game is equipped to handle damage like that. That's just nuts. That is nuts. Hey, can you drop this thing so we can drop the Mutant Elite with the mech and we can keep everyone alive? That'd be great. If you don't mind. Thanks. Cheers. Obliged. Thank you.
Start keeping score.
Yeah. You know what really was a good score? You dropping that damn ethereal. That was the big score. Everything else is secondary. Alright. So we can easily drop this fellow now with some hit and run damage. And really the biggest threat is now kind of dealt with. We have 19 charges on repair servos. We're going to try to make use of as many of those as possible. Heal up 9 damage before we go in on Ray. Now this thing is pretty evasive. Alright, Tyler. You're going to have to go ahead and get me a holo because I don't want to miss this and then... suddenly have someone drop from the other massive dangerous thing that's in this pack. Go right there. That's the flank. Yeah, it's the flank.
I'm on it,
I like how they keep trying to attack Nova on the flanks, though. Like, whenever there's a flanking and Nova's involved, they always go after the scout. Not sure why. It's a Mutant Elite thing, I guess. Now, where's our flanking mech? There we go. Alright, Smile. Finish this sucker off. Thank you. Whew. Okay, that was the nastiest pack in the game that we've
eliminated.
Seen so far, I think.
Cover position.
Anytime there's
here
a double ethereal is bad. That one had an Overmind in it, which is even worse. So Dead luckily, block. Everyone's still somewhat alive.
Let's rock.
Take the opportunity for reloads. Ray's gonna take the opportunity for heals, because Nova got a little beat up there. It's kind of the danger of this middle section here, but we have 8 medkits. We should be able to top everybody off. No one has taken any more damage beyond armor, which is important. Even our mech, who took a giant chunk of health out, I think we're actually okay. Yeah, we're gonna be waiting for those things to repair. Remember, we still have cyber discs that we heard. And we got friends. Oh, we got lids, we got lids, we got lids.
Got something over here.
Got a lot of lids, got a lot of lids, got a lot of lids, got a lot of lids. Those were not expected. But these generally can be dealt with okay. Luckily, we took the reloads, so that's going to help us out. In the zone is going to be instrumental in making this work better. That is a lot of lids, and they definitely jumped around us. So the question is going to be, can we actually get out of here without dying horribly? I think the answer is going to be yes. It's just going to require us to do some good movement. Practically... Oh, no, I think everyone has a way out. As long as Tyler moves his ass, be okay. Yeah, no, I think this should be fine. This should be fine. Worst comes to worst, we come in with a flamethrower and we panic all of them. Downside is Tony Blair's a little far, so our kind of mainline ass kicker is not there. But we can kind of get Tony in from this end and do some shotgun work there. So it's not a total loss. If worst comes to worst, we'll go ahead and panic these suckers, and then we'll have some good damage. But remember, we also have a high explosive capable unit here, so it's all right. Glad I brought them proxies, though. You're almost out of ammo, but again, cover doesn't matter here, so let's go ahead and just drop this thing. It's the only thing you can fire at anyway. One less lid to worry about. We're going to have some fun now. We're going to have some fun. Tyler can get over here. But I do want him to double tap more. Hank, where are you? Gonna need you to start setting up ITZ shots here. Yeah, I need you to go ahead and get up here and start zoning stuff. In the zoning stuff. Alright, take that shot. We also have Nova to set the up to the end of the zone, so this is okay. And this is gonna take another chunk of the alien numbers out as well. So we interrupt this healing for this important news bolt and get the hell out of here. I may just go ahead and drop a grenade on this. It'll make things a lot easier. I do have the double tap option still, but I think it'll just be better to grenade the crap out of this and have some fun with it. Are you a big guy? You're a charger. What kind of lids are you, actually? Is there any particular danger? These are mostly baseline lids, just late game lids. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna try to knock this charger out if possible. It's gonna help us get some nice kills. 10 is kinda nice. It's good damage. Yeah, we should have this in the bag, pretty much. And worst comes to worst, we'll save the, yeah, I think we're gonna save the flamethrower for a last ditch effort. I think we can do everything else fine here. We need to clear out this area a bit so we can launch a grenade without putting ourselves in threat.
Got it covered.
But Ray, again, we're gonna keep trying to set up in the zones for Hank because he's gonna be instrumental in doing this well for us. 84. Was there not a 96 that I just saw? There we go. Do that. 8 damage. A little low, but Hank should be able to mop that one up fine. So I got 7 HP left, so even on a bad roll. What is my damage? 12. I could roll badly. I'm a little worried about that. It's kind of not enough, so I'm going to go ahead and get that clean kill. That better be a kill. Hank, don't screw with me. Thank you. Oh, the camera didn't do the action camera thing, so I was a little worried. I'm like, wait a minute. We're going to get Plank Bob airborne too, just in case the worst should happen. Going to get this rolling up this way. Gonna try to set up some more kills. Cause this keeps you safe from lids. Don't do lids, friends. Don't do lids. Alright. We can set up. Is that the last unit that's close? And Nova's still pretty close. But we can depend on her for some in the zone work as well. Fine. Let's get Cairo out of here and toss one grenade into this position. We'll retreat a little bit just so we can clear the blast area. Set this one for all down, launch a grenade so we can whittle this down, set this up for Hank a little better. We're gonna bust up two computers here, but again, not a major priority. We're short on power supplies and not computers. Can we not do this now? Can we just put the grenade in between these guys and call it a day? Is that fine? Is this okay for everybody? Yeah, good. Stop doing that targeting computer or I will stab you in the face. There we go. Targeting successful. Good. Okay, now, yeah, like I said, this can be now generally handled. All right, Nova, start running out of ammo. 92, huh? How about you don't miss these shots, yeah? Wouldn't that be good? Wouldn't that be great not to miss these shots? Thanks, good. There's one. Give me another. Yep, handled. Oh, the poor lids. Their corpses litter the ground. Oh, gun is dry already. Okay, well, you're not going to be able to pull your gun kata stuff anymore because you're kind of out of ammo.
Good to go.
Take a reload. All right, Plank Bob, why don't you get yourself a kill here, buddy? Kind of want to set this up, though, because Hank's going to have an easy kill on this. Maybe get a kill there. If not, done. Plank Bob wanted that kill. All right, Hank's going to get this in a reload. No problem. Done. Okay, we didn't need the fire at all, which is great. So we have 30 A's down, about 22 left, so we're looking at maybe 3 more packs, potentially 4 if the packs are small. There could be a big daddy pack somewhere with a nasty mech unit, so we got to be very cognizant of that. I would have liked to get a little more time to heal, but, you know, sometimes you can't. We're going to get that done, get those repair servos working. Luckily, we took no more damage, so we're still okay. Still got a cyber disc running around. Still got mutons running around. There could be more muton elites here. I'm just gonna be hoping upon hope, that we don't have to run into another ethereal pack. That one was nasty enough, and I'm content never seeing another one like that in a while. So I'm pretty happy if that ever happens again. But so far we've dealt with the major threats here. It's been a rough one though. I mean, that's how scary that Overmind is, honestly. You've got double proxy and a blaster launcher projectile, and that thing still kind of goes, that scratched, and it was like at half HP and then healed up. That's just nuts, man. That enemy is just not fair on a lot of levels. But luckily, like I said, we handled it. We're going to, like I said, wait a little bit here just to make sure that we can cover ourselves appropriately. Make sure we're all healed up before we move forward. The last thing we want to do is go to aggro at this point. Since our rounds are low, we're kind of all a little bit out of position. Now we need the opportunity to refit. Shouldn't cover and get that set up. Alright. Got the repair servos working. That's... Okay, there's another group out there. Okay. We got something.
Enemy in sight.
Got mutons. We got a sectoid commander. Mutons are taking high ground. So not awesome. We're not getting a lot of time to heal up here before we're hitting more threats. So that's less than awesome. Tyler's in a bit of a bad spot right now. But, oh wait, they don't see him. Oh god, this is open. I didn't realize this is open. I thought this was backed up. Okay. Oh, the hits just keep on coming, don't they? Do we have eyes on these enemies via air? We do not. A little worried about Hank at this point. Don't want him to get caught out. And I don't want him to get close enough that the thing can actually snipe him. Because Hank's going to need to get up here, obviously, but... that green circle means no bueno for me. I have to deal with that mechtoid yesterday. Alright, Ray may need to pop a smoke here because they do have elevated ground on us, so that's not good. What can we do? Does that thing have reactives? If it doesn't have reactives, then I'll be okay. No reactives, basic mechtoid. So what's actually in this pack? We have a mind controller, a mechtoid, and 5 mutons. A lot of M's. Okay, we don't need Shred here, I think. The mechtoid will be weak enough that we can kind of just drop it. We do need to worry about Overwatch from it, so we're going to have to go ahead and deal with that. Alright. You know what? I think we'll be okay without smoke. So, Ray, go ahead and top off Nova so she can run up forward.
You'll be back in the fight ASAP.
I'm a bit worried about my heavy mech that's taking heavy damage. I don't want her to lose some repair servo charges, but that may be kind of a foregone conclusion at this point. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that these shots on the mechtoid connect. So we're going to set up a holo. Nice, 10 damage. That guy's really sprinted. That mechtoid really wanted to get this engagement early. Not sure why this happened, though. We didn't activate the command pack, but it does feel like stuff is beelining for us, which is not cool. But Beth can always give as good as she got, so 10 damage there. Might be able to drop it with one more shot, potentially, which wouldn't be bad. Yep. Handled. Very nice.
Target disabled.
Target more than disabled. Target is down. Okay, and now we get to play How Do You Want to Die Today? It's my favorite game. Alright, let's see. So Tyler being covered from elevated position is not good, but this is going to give him some vision. Remember, the mutons are on the high ground, so I can't really expose myself too much without, exposing myself. So let's see if we can just take a peek.
Okay, go loud!
Shit. Okay. That now is not good. You had to see the Outsider pack, didn't you? Okay. Outsider pack, Cyberdisc pack. Okay, so this makes it more interesting. Now we've got to revise our approach a tad. Especially because now we're about to get flanked from here. So Nova's about to take another chunk of pain. So Kyra's gonna need to provide temporary cover. Otherwise we're gonna get flanked to death. Ray's still in this directional cover, so that's fine. I might need to launch a shred in that direction. I think I may need to launch a shred in that direction. It's not optimal because I don't have, again, a good engagement on that. Goody goody gumdrops. All right, we're gonna launch a shred into here. Is this worth it to shred the cyber disc? Luckily, it's not a boss cyber disc, just a basic one. So we should be able to get nice shred damage on all of this here. And they're all above ground, they're all mechanical. We should be able to do some good work here. And let's hope that actually pans out. So go ahead and send the shred.
Fighting rocket.
Yeah, we dropped a lot of them, and we shredded the cyber disc, so that's a lot less drones we have to worry about. Now it's down to one cyber disc. Okay, so that pack is handled with one rocket.
God, I love the blaster launcher.
It's good stuff. Okay, so Tyler, who screwed this up in the first place, we're gonna need you. We'll set an overwatch on him. Heat-related. Hank, I gotta be a little careful on. We're gonna put him out here if we can to get some vision on these positions, but I'm a bit worried because there could be, like, I don't want him to get mind controlled. That's really what I'm freaked out about. Looks like the only piece of vision we have. Looks like the mutants did book out this way. Hank, do you have a good shot on this? Got a 77, which may kill. We do have a grenade. I might as well start weakening this muton because if Hank can drop him, then there's going to be no vision on where we're at, and that would be very advantageous. Now we hit something else down there. Okay, so there's definitely something by the side of the UFO there. Should be interesting. And Cairo freaked out. That's not really what I wanted to see. Goody goody gumdrops. Let's see, Tony Blair. I would like Tony to go ahead and give me hit and run here. I'm a little worried about what may be out this way. I don't see anything via Hank. I think this is relatively clear though. This is the only thing that has another position on it. Now, Hank can't get flank from here. So Tony would be flying blind a little bit, and I don't like that. I may have to put her out here and get a flank with the plasma pistol, which is fine, because then we're going to be in hit and run zone. And I don't mind her coming out in the front line, because again, she is uncrittable, so, you know, let assaults do what assaults do, effectively. Get right there. That way we'll be able to have a little bit of cover from anything coming out from this way. We'll have eyes on it. And Hank will be in a little better spot. Really? Plasma pistol. How does he have... He's flanked. 79? Ah, 1 HP. Come on, guys. Hank, do you have Executioner? You don't. But he's got this. Hank's got this. He got that at 77. He's got that at 50 paces. Not too shabby, buddy. All right, Tyler sent me a set in Overwatch. Let's see how this goes. We're gonna feel it from the repair servos, though. I'm not gonna be keen on this. Because we're gonna obviously go into, I think,
that's a load of
health damage, and that's not good. We didn't get enough time to repair. Oh no, he just overwatched, which is great. Mutant's here, Mutant's not happy. Mutant's running, and we're running, and we're running, and we're sitting. Mutant on the roof. He's gonna drop and probably take a pot shot at Tyler, which is probably gonna hit. No, he double moved. Okay. Aggressive, aggressive. That went a lot better than expected. I kind of figured I was going to get hit harder on that, but now it looks like things have more or less stabilized. Okay, solid. All right, the aliens did me a solid, and I kind of thank them for that. Gave me a little bit of time to breathe. It's not going to be good for them. It's going to be good for me. So I'll pick this up next time. Thanks so much for tuning into this episode of The Long War, and I will see you all as we continue this raid. We've hit probably the worst pack we've done already, and then the rest is going to be more or less cleanup. We can't get too comfortable, but after this, it's going to be 45 aliens left. I mean, 45 aliens down, which means probably one more pack for the command, and we should be good. Till that time, though, I'll see you then. Till then.